Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about buying and re-releasing source code. Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in from episode 371 from Mustafa Asi. And he said, hello, nice video. I want to ask a question. What do you think about buying Android source code for about $50 to $100 and then adding some ads in it and release it to the Play Store, give it some good keywords, and then advertise it? Would it be a good way to make money? That's something that a lot of people did a few years ago. It was called reskinning. So back in 2012, 2013, 2014, I knew a lot of people where they didn't write their own code. They just reskinned things, which was actually pretty good because it would take a good concept and it would add a new theme to it. Like, let's say you buy some source code to a game that's like, well, Flappy Birds is an excellent example. I knew so many people who put out Flappy Birds clones. I wasn't one of them, but they would take, like, they would buy the source code, and it wasn't the actual source code of Flappy Birds, but it would be, somebody would just clone it. So they would clone it and sell it because they would make more money selling it than they would releasing it onto the App Store, which tells you something, really. Right, so they would release Flappy Fish or Flappy Birds with better graphics or whatever, and there were so many clones of it, it was ridiculous. And this is one of the reasons why we have rules like 4.3, because the people were putting out like loads of apps onto the App Store. In fact, I knew a lot of people, that was the language they used. Like, I have a factory. Basically, I've got these outsourced people, and they would just one or two games a day, or some people I knew 10 games a day, and they would just put them out onto the App Store, and they would just keep changing keywords and putting things out there, and they would write, and then when that stopped working, then they would write books saying how to make money reskinning, right? So, and I talked about this before, and that's mostly on the Apple side, right? And they do it on Google Play too, right? There's been a couple times where I purchased source code, but the one time where I released something to Google Play, it was removed within like 6 hours. And it was like a Swing Copters clone, right? And we changed everything to make it like spy themed to reach out to the ear spy people, right? So I thought if they go to more like this app, they would see something else that was spy related, and then maybe that would get them in and everything like that. That was my logic, and like within 6 hours it was suspended, right? And I didn't even appeal it. I probably should have appealed it, you know, in retrospect, because I wasn't the only person doing reskins, right? But I just kind of felt like I didn't really like it because I'm a developer, and I hire developers, and I didn't like the idea of it. But a lot of people do. A lot of people do it, and a lot of people have made money from it. And I don't know if it's still the same now. I think it would be hard on Apple. I don't know so much on Google. One thing I would say, though, if you are going to go that route, and there's websites like Chupa Mobile, Ragdog Studios is one. I think it's Ragdog Studios. So there's ways you could do that, and there's still methods out there. So we could buy source code, right? So, but one of the things I did find when I buy source code, it's almost like it's like really good looking at somebody else's source code, because then you can see what they're doing, right? So one of the things about these, all the source code that I bought, that was actually pretty well documented, because they have to give it to you in a way that you could customize it. So not just adding new graphics and new audio files, but maybe even add some new code. So the code is, in all the cases where I purchased it, was really well documented, and it sort of helped learn certain things. Like, because when you do things on your own, you may follow a few different tutorials and examples, but then when you see the way other people do it, oh, I see they've encapsulated all the ad logic into this module, or they've done this over here and they've done that, and just really cool to see the way that it works. So I think it's good, especially if you're like you're first starting out into the app market and you just want to see what it's like. But to answer your question, I don't think you would really get rich off of it, because, I mean, there's a reason why they sell the source code and not just keep re-releasing these games over and over again. It's because that, you know, building the app, and I tell this to every client we ever have, building the app's the easy part. Actually getting people in to find it, that's the hard bit. So, I mean, I can understand the logic, right? If you bought the source code and you just changed it slightly, or changed it, even if you changed it a lot, and then you had, you know, people coming into it, and if it was a success, then yeah, that's an easy way to make money. But it's actually harder than that, because you probably need ads to get them in to find it, and then whether or not you can make ads from it. So for me, I've never had success with it. I've known very few people who have. I know lots of people who've tried, but especially in the early days, I think people had more success with it, but not so much now. So my question to you guys out there today is, for those of you who do I mean, is anybody out there still doing reskinning? And if so, I mean a purchasing quote from, and I don't mean hiring people to do the code for you. I mean purchasing, like, you know, the something from Chupa Mobile or whatever. Chupa Mobile, one of the other studios. Code Canyon has them too, right? Just going out there and purchasing the code and re-releasing it and just changing the graphics. Have you had success doing that, right? For me, I've never, the few times where I've purchased the code, I mean, but I've changed it so much where I might as well have just written it myself. But it's that learning exercise, especially when you're just learning a new language. Like for me, it was Lua and Corona. It was like seeing the way other people were doing it. It was like hugely beneficial. So anyway, so that's just, you know, my experiences, what I think. I'd like to know what you guys think about that. And that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.